is our first Global Impact Celebration here at this church, and it has just been beyond my wildest imagination in terms of the success of it. Didn't quite know what to expect heading into our first one, but it has been outstanding, starting with our opening kickoff service on Wednesday night.
And Lord, we want you to take our hearts and just explode them with love for you, for lost people all around this world.
It's incredibly important. There is no substitute for personal exposure to other cultures and other peoples. Because those of you who have gone, you know what happens to you. God breaks your heart for people and places.
It's been really good to find out the information about the missions we're supporting and the items we're doing. I've been a member of the Church Missions Committee for the past about 12 years now, and I learned a lot.
I've been to a service where I've got to see people from different cultures, different countries interact, and worship is one. And you really get to see how, even though they're on the other side of the world, that you know they all worship the same God.
Listening to all the stories that the missionaries have shared has been very enlightening. For example, at the international banquet Friday night, the congregation or the audience there was encouraged to submit questions specifically to the missionaries. And some of them were very serious questions, some of them were rather lighthearted, but they were all very worthwhile to hear their responses.
It's been humbling for me not only to see their hearts, but also their lives and what exactly what they're going through, the intimate details of what they struggle with and what they rejoice in every day.
Meeting the missionaries that have been here and getting to know them and hear their stories and just get a feel for what life is like for them out in the field.
And so as we are sharing what is going on there, some of them do have some insights that they do share with us and gets us excited. We can't wait to get the field so we can also apply that and see the work go forward. So it's really a give and take. And that's been exciting for me, making wonderful friends and building great relationships.
As part of the Global Impact Celebration, we're doing some real life mission work in our own backyard. What we're doing is some yard work for one of our church members that, due to health issues, can't do their own yard work.
This, I know, has been an inspirational time for all of us, seeing the missionaries. And now I have missionaries here that are from my own church.
Today, as part of our Global Impact Celebration, we're going to conduct a food drive here at Food Lion in Chapin, and then later on this afternoon at Philo Store.
And we are here for Kindness Outreach Days, collecting non-perishable foods and monetary donations to help support the food pantry in Chapin.
The people have been just more than friendly. I guess they can see the connection that we are all serving the Lord and the Spirit of God has connected us. And it's been wonderful to be here, not only for the missions, but to meet my brothers and sisters that I've never seen before, but the Lord had us together. So it's wonderful to be here, and the experience has been heavenly.
Helping to really grow this idea of missions in the church and apply it to the people's hearts, and so that they would carry this on into something greater and hopefully just grow the church into a more missional church.
Having these kind of events, we'll have a revival, a spiritual revival, that everybody will get involved in, wanted to go in some way. If they don't go to the mission field, they would like to support missionaries.
I would encourage other churches that are looking at perhaps expanding their missions outreach, that they consider conducting a Global Impact Celebration of their own.
Based on our experience, I would say this would be a fantastic opportunity for any church to do a similar type of event.
I would recommend the Mission Society's program for Global Impact to every church. We knew we felt God calling us to do more, to go outside of our community in a greater way, but didn't have a clue about how to do it. And the Mission Society came alongside of us, gave us freedom to be who we are, gave us freedom to seek God and to seek His precise, clear vision for us as an individual church, but gave us the practical steps, the manual, here's a tried and true method that if you'll just work and allow God to work this process, you can trust God in this process. And that's what we did. We had an incredible team of people who did that. And It was so beautiful to see it all come together.